Today, I'm going to show you how to schedule appointments optimally with Spring Boot and Timefold AI. Let's get started. We go to start.spring.io, and here we're going to create an application. I'll use Maven in this example, but you can also use Gradle, of course. And I'm going to call it the Timefold Spring Demo. There we go. I'm going to add some dependencies. Specifically, I'm going to add the web dependency of Spring Boot so we can create an easy, simple REST method. And then I'm going to add the Timefold dependency so we can use that to schedule those appointments optimally. Here we go. And now I'll just generate that. And let's open that up in IntelliJ. Okay, here in this application, we're going to go to the demo application of Spring Boot. And we're going to create a few extra classes to be able to schedule those appointments optimally. So the first thing we need is an appointment class. So here we go. We create an appointment class. An appointment has a certain name. For example, it could mean I need to go to a doctor or to the dentist or things like that. So let's give that a name. Here we go. An appointment also has a certain duration. So let's, for example, half an hour and things like that. And an appointment will need a starting time, right? So here we go. Now, with the duration and with the start time, there's also automatically an end time, but we can actually calculate that. So let's say that the end time is also a local time, of course, and that's just the start time plus the duration. So we're going to take the start time and we're going to add the duration. There we go. Looks like a good appointment class. We're going to want to optimize this with Timefold, and Timefold will have to fill in the start time for us. So in our test data that we create, we need a constructor for that. We only need to fill in the name and the duration, not the start time. That will actually start an ULL, and that will be filled in by the solver for us. The solver does require, and as well as Jackson, both Timefold and Jackson require actually an empty constructor. So let's add that for them. And Jackson also requires that there's getters and setters for all of our fields, or at least getters. So let's do that. Let's generate those getters and setters. Timefold needs to know what it can change from the appointments. It cannot change the name or the duration of the appointment, but it can change the start time and actually must change the start time. So first of all, this is the class that Timefold can make changes on. So let's call that, let's annotate that with a planning entity. So Timefold knows I can change stuff in there. And specifically, it can change the start time. And so let's actually add a planning variable annotation there. So Timefold knows I need to fill in the start time of these appointments. Great. Now we have something we can start scheduling. But of course, we will have multiple appointments and we need something to keep all of those appointments and send that back from our REST method, as well as also to give it to Timefold. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a schedule. And that actually has a list of all of the appointments. So a list of the appointments. But it also has a list of the start times. So we'll go just create that too. Because Timefold cannot just pick any start time or create start times. We actually want to say, okay, we only want to assign start times, for example, in the afternoon. So we'll give you a list from start times to pick from for the different appointments, right? So, and this is actually exactly what this is. Now, this is the thing we're actually going to give to Timefold, and this is then called a planning solution. Why? Because we give it to Timefold and we get it returned from Timefold with all of the appointments assigned. Therefore, it's called a planning solution. We need to tell them where to get those planning entities, those appointments. So we need to add an annotation here and say, okay, the appointments is actually your collection of planning entities, which you need to fill in for where you find the start times to fill in for us. And we also need to tell them where he can find the start times to pick from, and that's with a value range annotation. Okay, great. Now, when we actually have this solved, Timefold will automatically assign a score to it. And let's actually visualize that score. That's useful. And so the way you do that is you add a planning score annotation on the hard soft score field. So now whenever Timefold actually optimizes the schedule, it will fill in the score for you based upon how good or how bad the schedule is based upon the constraints you've defined. Great. We want to create some test data around this. So let's create a constructor that actually fills in the appointment and the starting times. No need to fill in the score as that will be done for us, right? And as we need to send this over Jackson and also give it to Timefold, let's also create an empty constructor. And for Jackson, we will want a bunch of getters and setters too. So let's generate those two. So this comes nicely back from the JSON method. Great. Now we have our schedule class. And so now we can go to our demo application and Spring Boot, and we can create a simple REST method. So let's do that. Let's say this is a REST controller. I'm going to create a simple REST method that returns a schedule, right? The schedule. And this is going to be a get mapping, and we'll just let it run on the root, which is easy. Now, first, before we can solve a schedule, we need to actually generate a schedule. So let's actually use this code that I've pre-prepared, which is a bit of test data with some appointments and with some starting times. Let's go through this. So the appointment is, there's an appointment for a doctor of an hour, an appointment for going to the pub for 4 hours, and an appointment for going to the barber for 70 minutes. And we can pick to do any of these appointments at 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, or 6 o'clock in the afternoon. This is the problem we'll actually give to the solver. So let's actually ask for something to solve that. And so let's auto-wire a solver manager. So a solver manager is a thing that can solve this problem for us. This is a solver manager for schedules, and the type of jobs we send it, we need to have an ID, and the type of that ID is a string. So that's why we specify it like this. Okay. So here's our solver manager that gets injected. So what we're going to do is we're going to case solver manager, please solve this problem for us. Now, we do need to give it an ID. So let's say job one. All right. And please solve this problem for us. Here we go. And this will return us a solver job. Why? Because solving it can take a long time if you have a big data set. So it could take like 5 minutes or something like that. Way too long for your HTTP timeout limits that you're dealing with. So what you want to do is typically solve this asynchronously. If you have like thousands of appointments, tens of thousands of appointments and so forth. But in this case, we don't. So we're just going to wait for the best solution. And we can do this by on the solver job saying, just wait for the final best solution and return that. Now that does throw a few exceptions. So let's just add those to the method signature. But of course, in a real application, you would need to deal with those properly. Again, this is because this is solved after on a separate thread to not hog your REST methods. Here, this is our solution. All right. And we're going to just return solution. Great. Now, one more thing before we can get started, we need to actually specify how long we want to solve. So let's go to the application properties. Let's say, okay, for Timefold Solver, you can solve for 1 second. And then you need to return. Now, the more time you give it, the better your solution will be. But in this particular case, it will actually just, it's a very easy case. It will solve optimally in way before that. Here we go. So we need one more thing, and that's the constraints. What do we want it to improve in our appointments, in our schedule? But for now, I'm going to create a constraint provider, right? To hold those constraints. And so we're going to implement the constraint provider interface. Let's say, look, here's a list of all of the constraints we have. But for now, I'm going to leave that empty. So no constraints. So you can do whatever you want. Let's just see how that works out for us. And if you want to change something about that. Here we go. We run the demo application of Spring Boot. Starting now. So now we can go to localhost. Now that we solved it, let's take a look at the result we get. So of the first appointment to the doctor for an hour, it actually filled in a start time for us at 3 o'clock. If you look at the second appointment and third appointment, they actually also are filled in to 3 o'clock. So even though Timefold did fill in the start appointments for it, it did that quite badly. And the reason for that is because there are no constraints. So it just filled it in to whatever it wanted. Now, if we actually go back and we say, okay, we don't want to have these kinds of overlapping constraints where we need to be at two or three places at the same time. we need to add a constraint to actually do that. So what we're going to do is we're going to, in our constraint of provider, we're going to say, okay, I want to add an extra constraint. And that particular constraint is is about overlapping. So let's call that overlaps. Overlapping time. All right. And let's create a constraint around that. Here we go. And create a new method for that. You can do that in there, of course, too. And we're going to say, okay, constraint factory. Whenever you have overlapping appointments, we want you to penalize that with a hard constraint. So we don't want you to do that. So we're going to do a four unique pair. And that will give us two appointments that are unique, so that it's not the same appointment twice, but it's also not the appointment A, B, and then the appointment B, A as a pair. Be able to do that, we need to, Timefold needs to recognize when two appointments are the same or not. And the easiest way to do that is just to go to your appointment and say, okay, I need a planning ID. I have a planning ID there, and my name in this case is unique. So I can actually use that as the planning ID, so that all that Timefold knows that when it has two appointments, when they're unique and when they're not. Okay. So now we have a unique pair of appointments. And when is it the problem? When they're actually overlapping. So let's do that. Let's say when you're overlapping. And Timefold actually has an out-of-the-box support for overlapping, to detect overlapping. And so this is an overlapping joiner, which means that it will now select in a very efficient way two appointments that are overlapping. And to be able to tell which how they're overlapping, we need to give it the start and end of an appointment. So we need to tell them, okay, here's how you determine the start of an appointment. That's appointment get start. And this is how you define the end of an appointment with appointment get end. And now we've actually selected two appointments that are overlapping. And so that's a bad thing. If there's any in there in our data set, we don't want that. So we want to penalize that. As you saw earlier, we're using a hard and soft score. So let's just do a hard score here. All right. And let's say this is the overlapping time constraint, right? There we go. So now we have now we have that constraint where we say, select me two appointments that are overlapping in time. If you do, hit Timefold on the head. So don't do that anymore. And we call that the overlapping time constraint. If we now actually restart our Timefold, our Spring Boot application, and we go back to localhost and we refresh that, what you will see is that it solved it again. All of the appointments are now assigned to start time again. But the doctor's appointment is at 3 o'clock, ending at 4 o'clock. And the barber appointment is at 4 o'clock, ending at 5:10. And the pub appointment is last at 6 o'clock, leading all the way until in the evening until 10 p.m. So as you can see, we now have a feasible schedule. Still maybe not the optimal schedule because we only have hard constraints. And what you might want to add is a soft constraint at this point. So a soft constraint could be that you want to actually maximize the time between your appointments. And in fact, if you would switch the barber appointment and the doctor appointment, maybe that's a better schedule for you. You can be a bit late at the pub maybe, right? So in that case, you want to add soft constraints in your constraint provider to actually shape your schedule in a way that is just better for you. But that, of course, depends on your taste and what kind of constraints you want to add. As you can see in the end, the current score is 0 hard, 0 soft, because all of the constraints we have defined are actually adhered to, so we have a perfect score. If you want to try this out yourself, go to start.spring.io and start using the Timefold solver dependency there.